first one that we want to do is the best table display. And I'm so happy. No, just kidding. I love those events too. So this was the people's choice. This was, of course, the cards that they filled out that were in the program. So you guys all chose for the best table display the purple peanut.
I don't know which one it was.
We'll see it tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
See it tomorrow, yes.
So Ashley, this is her first year actually being a vendor.
It was very creative.
So that's awesome. Good job, Ashley.
Oh, I think I know which one it is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Cool. That's a very nice.
No, actually, if Sarah and Letha could come up. Okay, the next one that they chose is the best booth display. And the booth, the best booth goes to Pixie Mountain Creations.
I voted for Lori, yeah. Yay, Lori! Woohoo!
Yes, Lori! Yay, Lori!
Congrats! Right. Oh my goodness, awesome! Woohoo!
Fabulous.
This is also Lori's first year as a vendor.
Awesome. I know, she's just awesome. Yay!
I'm so glad she did.
I know, I'm happy for her.
Okay, the people's choice for the best hair rooting goes to Jacqueline Kramer. Wow. Also, we want you to go ahead and get your dolls off of the display table and bring them up with you for the pictures. Okay, the best hair painting for the People's Choice was
Jackie,
Maria Valle Escudero.
That's Jackie Kramer.
And then the people's choice for the most realistic goes again to Jacqueline Kramer.
Well, we didn't know it was Jackie.
No, we didn't know. Mm-hmm.
It's her Kyrie. Mm-hmm. One of her Kyrie.
Oh, oops.
We really appreciate all of the contest entries that were done. We had a phenomenal amount with amazing.
She made clothes too.
Quality of work for each
Spanish and Spanish knit.
Okay, so what was at her booth?
I need to go look at that tomorrow because
really
I didn't really.
She said she's getting tired of making dolls, so she
you know, join in the contest and make it a success.
She's been doing it for 25 years.
Wow. Something different, yeah. Mix it up, right?
She's just tired of it now.
So we wanted to do the people's choice that weren't associated with the categories that we were giving out. And so now we're going to go ahead and go to the categories. And we're going to start with the beginning reporting.
If they call one of us, you might need to hold our phone.
Oh, I'm getting ready.
So third place on the reporting beginner. And goes to, and this was really hard because there were so many great ones on there. But the third place goes to Sarah Merritt. If you could please get your doll and come bring it up for pictures.
Where are the dolls? Are they back there?
Oh, there, yeah. They're back there.
And we do have a lot of awards to get through, so we are going to just keep moving along with them. And so the second place on the Reborn Beginner goes to Ashley N. Stone.
Oh,
And then the first place, Reborn Beginner. Gita
Grand. That's not fair. Huh? She's not a beginner. That's okay.
If you want to get your doll, Gita and Mika. What?
Yeah.
Okay, come on up and we'll get that for you. Okay, and then the people's choice for the Reborn Beginner, Ashley Ann Stone.
How do you know she's been doing it for a while?
She's been so
So let's give another round of applause for the beginning category.
So don't feel bad.
To go back and look through all of the contests.
She won first and third.
So if you haven't had a chance to look at them, go ahead and look at them before you go because they really did do a lot of work into them.
Oh, they haven't announced first yet.
How many of you can actually see the trophies?
They haven't announced first yet. For
it does have the Baby of the Year on the top. It was sculpted by Elsie.
Baby of the Year?
They give the trophy.
And donated by Elsie Rodriguez.
Yeah, so I think that's...
And of course, the beautiful bird bath to go with our theme for Enchanted Garden. So Peter gets the first one.
Maybe they're interpreting it as, this is the first time I've ever entered a baby, so I'll put it in the beginning. No, that didn't look like a beginner's baby.
Okay, we're going to go ahead and go on to the Reborn Intermediate. And for third place, for Reborn Intermediate, was Mandy Flanagan.
She's from the Bountiful Baby.
Second place in the Reborn Intermediate goes to Karen Bolton.
Yeah.
And the first place for the intermediate category goes to Murthy Koi. Oh, I think I said that right.
Who is this blonde here, right there with the striped? Who's the blonde with the striped shirt?
Black. Since she's on her way up, we'll go ahead and announce the people's choice.
She's Karen
Bolton.
She's a painter. She has a really good painting.
Nice dawn.
Mm-hmm.
Let's hear it for all the intermediate winners. Okay, the advanced category. And this is actually the second biggest category that we had entries in. The first one was the beginners. And so we'll go ahead and announce the third place winner. The third place winner goes to Jeannie Larson.
Retiring.
Yeah, this is her last show. She's not doing any more dolls. Mm-hmm.
And the first place for the Reborn Advanced Group is Jacqueline Kramer.
I know, I think the little ring with the blanket is not going to cut it. You need a swan, you need balloons, you need, no, just kidding. Oh, what a cutie. I like that baby. She did a good job, yeah. It's really cute. Well, the cool thing is day two of the show.
And the People Choice Award for the Reborn Ethnic, since she's getting her picture taken right now, Kat Johnson.
That is a beautiful baby.
I love that one.
I did too.
Gorgeous.
Absolutely
gorgeous. That's the one.
That was the one I voted for that one too.
I don't want it.
I know.
I can't buy any more babies. No. So one of you ladies get it and I can watch it on your channel. her ethnic one. Because all the babies are for sale.
If anyone can see the cute little wings on the fairy.
A lot of the Collins babies are for sale. Oh, he was cute too. Oh, yeah. Very cute. Yeah, he's so cute.
Give another round of applause for the actors.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Second place for the fantasy / animal group, Rochelle Dyson.
Just confirmed, I'm a super slow eater.
And the first place for the fantasy animal group, Laurie Duncan.
We need to take display lessons from Lori.
Yeah.
Is she going to bring her whole thing? Oh, I'm so happy for her. I don't know. I'm not actually even sure which one was hers. But she won.
And the People's Choice Award for the fantasy group. So she's getting her picture taken right now. Rochelle Dyson.
I just recognized the dress.
This group had so many great creations in it. It was awesome. So let's give them another round of applause.
She just started playing the last year. She came to the show first time last year, took a fantasy class. First class, started rebounding a year ago. Yeah, as well.
Hey, our next group is the Silicones. We'll just go ahead and get started with those. Third place for Silicones, Maria Grover. Just say, I know I saw you. Just hit the button. The second place for the Silicone entries are Alejandra De Zuniga. And you know, we are going to go ahead and announce the first place also, because they were twins and they were beautiful. Oh, Alejandra De Zuniga. and do the People's Choice Award for the snow cones, Alejandra De Zuniga. So even though she kind of swept that group, there were so many great ones. The judging was really, for our judges, they had a really hard time deciding which ones to put where they need to go. So we just want to give our judges a round of applause for going, making sure that we are in the right way. Next award that we are going to give out, I am really honored to be able to talk about the person that I'm going to give this award to. She has done so many things to be able to become the Artist of the Year. She has been sculpting since she's 15 years old. I was like, woo!
Must be Jackal. Oh,
I think body brush. She has a passion that is unmatched and a talent that you just can't believe in seeing her work. She does sewing, drawing, writing. She writes children's stories. Mila was her first kit in 2006, and she was 16 years old. And she has sculpted over 25 kits that have been produced. That's pretty amazing.
Not 100%, that's my guess.
She has done sculpts for 11 silicones. Her greatest weakness is babies that stare at, and she stares at every baby that she sees. Her greatest strength is never giving up, but she really doesn't like mean people. No, sorry, I don't know. And the Illegal Kids Productions. Her goals are to always keep learning, to be able to have a family, and her favorite sculpt is twin A and B. Mm-hmm. She sells locally to dealers that are local and international, and she has sold over 7,000 kits.
Wow.
I know, right? That's
I have no idea either.
She breeds guinea pigs. That was kind of crazy. And she has 24 of them. And she's an animal lover because she also has 4 cats, 2 birds, and a parakeet. On the way that she names her kits, she likes kits that, on the names, then she likes them that hasn't been used very much. And I just am blown away by her work. And meeting her at the show, she's just seems like the nicest person, and I'm so glad to be able to present Artist of the Year to Bonnie Brown.
Thank you.
her in the hall.
We just have to give her a round. Our next award is the Lifetime Achievement Award. And our recipient that has been chosen this year is just someone else who I just, every time I see her, I just love to talk to her. She's so sweet and so nice and just classy. She's classy. I'd like to read the write-up that she has on her website. And she says, "I have loved dolls my whole life. I've made dolls since I was a little girl. I made them out of fabric, wood, buttons, porcelain, and almost anything else I could get my hands on. In 1995, I started creating small figurines and dolls out of polymer clay and selling them at local boutiques. And I established Sherry's Tender Treasures." It says, "About 6 years ago, I took sculpting class from Jack Johnston. I loved it and was hooked. After a few years, I started making baby dolls, and I love baby dolls. They remind me of those precious moments with my own children, and there's nothing as tender as a newborn baby." She loves to spend her days studying pictures of newborns, and she says, "It is amazing to me to see how different each tiny face is. It is my goal to bring to life those memories of our tiny babies that we hold dear and create a treasure that can be cherished for many years to come." She has been married for 30 years to a wonderful husband, Juan. They have 6 children, 4 adorable grandchildren. I'd like to also list some of her accomplishments. And I'm sure that her, she's got a ton more than what I'm gonna say. She does sculpt dolls for Paradise Galleries. And, let's see, 6 or 7? Yeah. 8, 6, and 7, her sculpts between 2 inches and 20 inches. And that is, I can't even imagine being able to do that. She has made dolls out of straw, cloth, cabbage patch, porcelain. She's made oaks. She's done wooden dolls, beads, miniature dolls. And she loves everything about making all dolls. And her goal is one day to do a full body silicone and painting silicone. I want to introduce our Lifetime Achievement Award to Sherry Williams.
Yay!